Hey guys, today I am doing a very special video. This is a collection video just of my full custom Pullip dolls. I should say full custom Pullip and family dolls because I have some Yolamays, I have a Taiyang now, I have my first custom Buell. I want you to see all of them. There's a couple of disclaimers I should make because you won't see all of them. So some of these dolls are in makeover mode. They might just be behind the scenes, so you might not see all of them in my collection. And a lot of times, I think this is natural, a doll collector's taste changes over time. You evolve, and I've certainly noticed that myself. So some of the dolls you might have remembered from my earlier videos are no longer in my collection. I've gifted them, I've sold them. So my collection's certainly different than it was even a year ago, which is kind of fun, kind of crazy. So if you don't see a doll, don't panic. There's probably a really good reason for that. I do want to dedicate this video to my friend Bruno because he's the one who gave me this idea. He has an incredible custom doll collection, and you know, I've enjoyed his photography on Instagram. You should follow him if you don't. I'll put the links. But what I thought I would do is, because there are so many, I thought that I would just kind of take you on a tour of my house with dolls on shelves so you could get kind of decent lighting and get close-ups of my lovely girls and boys. So I'm going to get out of the way here so you can see this first batch. I'm trying to set them up by artist as much as I can because, speaking of evolving, a lot of times an artist's work evolves over time, and I am certainly loyal to specific artists, and you'll see that. So anyway, I'm excited. Hope you're excited. So let's get started. All right. So on this first table, I have three artists' dolls. On my right side over here is my Charon doll collection. And in the middle is my Poison Girl doll collection. And then on the end is Aneva Queen. I'll kind of go through, this video will be 4 hours long if I talk about each doll, but I will say a couple of things about these dolls. So all the way on the end here, my Charon doll collection, this is to me one of those amazing things where you can see an artist really evolve over time. So at the very end is Heavenly with her pink and blue dress. That was my very first Charon doll. And just, you know, you can just see her style changing a little bit. There's carving work in some of the later dolls. The green girl in the middle, my matcha girl, love her. This is one of those dolls that has a very special meaning to me because I got her in London during the London meetup. That was just such an amazing time. So it's wonderful to look at these dolls and feel like, you know, they just represent something even more special than just the doll itself. And then next to her are my two kind of newer Charon dolls, Marina and Famiko. And I'm just floored by the amount of detail and styling and carving that Charon is now doing in her dolls. And I think she does Blythe dolls now, so that's kind of exciting too. And then the three girls right in the middle are my Poison Girl dolls. They are Danielle and Bunny, and gosh, you know, I just got the purple hair doll and I just did a video. I can't remember her name at the moment, but she's my favorite. Lavender's like my favorite color ever. So I've made her head to toe lavender, but all of these girls are just amazing. And I don't have to tell you guys that if you are lucky enough to get a Poison Girl doll, you really do feel this is something very special. It's a work of art. And then personally, I mean, I have a lot of favorite artists, but I remember the first time I saw an Aneva Queen doll, it was years ago. She was selling a beautiful kind of witch doll around Halloween. And I thought, my gosh, she's not charging enough. But luckily for me, she did face up, she did full customs, and that's kind of fun. So you can do a full custom doll. The brunette and sweet vanilla on the end are actually full custom head to toe. Where the artist kind of provided all the clothing and the styling and the shoes. And then my blonde girl in the middle was just a face up. And you'll find that a lot of artists are willing to do just a face up for you if you're interested in doing the styling for you yourself, or you have kind of a very specific idea in mind. All right, so let's move to the next room in the house. All right, so never mind the arcade cabinet in the background. I live in a house of fun, you guys. So these are a couple more artists that I really, really like. On the end here, this adorable girl with the bob is Peanut. Peanut and the blonde next to her, Sakura, are by Sophia Vanille. Absolutely love this artist. She does some amazing work. The next two dolls are by Rakeru Sensei. This is an incredibly talented artist who does face-ups for all kinds of ball-jointed dolls. And then the last five girls, because I have no control, are all by Miki Ochi. And this is kind of interesting because three of the girls you might recognize from previous videos are full custom. So I have Marie and Morel and Rose, who are all full custom dolls, and then the fluffy hat girl and the brunette at the end were just face-ups. I think I actually got one of them secondhand. So it's amazing what you can do if you are willing to do a little bit of styling yourself. Okay, so from the end, my brunette and the blue-haired girl next to her are both by Ovi Dolls. Ovi Dolls is a fantastic artist because, as you can see here, just the incredible range. She is really fantastic at making the doll that you really want and can kind of adapt her style. The next two girls next to them, my blonde and sort of my peach-haired girl, they look very similar because this is Namyens. This is a Thai artist who has been around for quite some time and has a very trademarked face, very specific look. So when you see a Namyens doll, you obviously know it's by Namyens. Now I've got these three girls that are kind of clustered together. These girls are so cute. Look at my Yolame, you guys. Ah, okay, so these are all by Miu Fish, a US-based artist. I've done reviews, I believe, of all of these dolls. But again, lots of color, lots of expression. I absolutely adore Miu Fish. And then I've got three girls right here in the middle. You might recognize also the style of these girls. There's Pancake, there is Sweet Tart, and there is this beautiful custom Sailor Moon Serenity. All of these dolls were done by Yummy Sweets. This is a very, very popular artist. These are incredibly unique, each one of them. And yet, Connie, the artist, has a very special style to her that you can recognize her work as well. All right, so the next two girls are by Atelier Baby's Breath. They look like they could be cousins, I think. I tried specifically to make them a little bit different in color. These were just custom face-ups. These weren't full custom dolls. The artist does a lot of face-ups for BJDs. I don't believe that she does any custom Pullip face-ups anymore, which is to me a shame because these are just some of the cutest dolls in my collection. And then last but not least on the end here, you'll recognize Big Hair Don't Care, Clementine right there, her sister. And then I also have a face-up by Jeanette of Project Dollhouse. Jeanette is an incredibly talented, I believe an architect, believe it or not. She does amazing work, so that I don't even know if she does face-ups for dolls anymore, but she is absolutely one of my favorite artists. These dolls are some of my favorites, and not just because they have giant hair. All right, so my next lineup of girls is ready for their close-up. I'll start with my little shorty there on the end. The blonde bob is on my Picarina doll. I'm a big fan of Picarina. I think that she has a lot of versatility and carving, and I love that this doll is actually on a Pure Nemo body instead of a Type 4. It's unusual for me. She's the only one in my collection like her, but I just think she's perfect as she is. Next to her was a very surprising ad for me. I had never heard of this this artist, but it's Dolls My, and I have seen more and more of the dolls that have come out by this artist, and I'm just blown away by the carving work, by the shading on the face. Absolutely had to have this doll. Next to her is my little goth girl, and this is by My Lovely Dollies. I found this artist on Instagram and absolutely fell in love because it is an unusual doll for me in my collection. The mocha girl next to her with the bob is by Snowing Creations. I keep telling myself that I need to get this doll a wig that has no bangs, because the reason why I love this artist and I found them on Etsy was she has very bushy eyebrows. So you should check out the video that I did on this doll, because she's so cute. All right, so the next two girls are very, very different, and they're by the same artist. They're by Lydia Tijon. Lydia is someone that I had found very early in my collecting, and at one point I think I had five of her dolls. They're all so different. She can do so many things, and I decided on one girl who is crying, which is incredible. She really does look like she's crying. And this sort of ethereal kind of wood nymph in my light-haired girl. And then the gal with the braids in the Wednesday Adam dress is by Bella Dalla. Big fan of Bella Dalla's as well. She does amazing carving work. I mean, this doll doesn't even look like a Pullip in the face. It's amazing what she can do. And then last but not least here is my doll by The Ugliest Wife. This is a Polish artist, and she does a little more darker, deeper depth in her dolls. And so this was a custom face-up that I had styled. All right, so on this shelf, I have two dolls on the very end by my friend Carla, and her shop is Carla's Dolly Atelier. And this was supposed to represent, I think, winter and spring. Love them, and I keep telling myself I need the other two seasons, but I don't. I mean, I need more dolls, but they're so cute. I love that they have kind of this natural look to them. Next to them is my Tsubasa doll that just came in. I've been obsessed with blue butterflies lately, and so she's very unusual for me, but absolutely love her. I think I want to change her wig to maybe a purple, but we'll get there. All right, so next to her is a beautiful, beautiful girl by my friend Maria. She is someone who is an incredible artist. She's super quiet about it, and she has, no joke, done at least two giveaway dolls for me, the face-up. And I'm like, I kind of need one of her dolls for my own collection. So that's why I had her do this gorgeous girl. All right, so the two girls immediately in the middle are by the same artist. They are by Kiki and Chrysanthemum. This is a very popular artist. They've been around for quite a few years, and it's a mother and daughter duo. So I never quite know who's doing face-up, who's doing clothes or whatever, but they are gorgeous. And they do face-ups, and I think they also do full customs. All right, so then I've got this fun collection of girls who, they're all just sort of one-offs. Like, I collect a lot of artists, like multiple dolls from the same artist, but then there are these, every once in a while, a doll that really just takes my breath away. And so this is just a fun collection of girls. So the little redhead kind of in the middle there, in her Sergeant Pepper outfit, is by a Thai artist named Kittazen. Kittazen's Dollhouse, I believe. And this guy is a total rock star. I mean, he literally looks like a rock star. His work is incredible. Next to her is my October doll by my friend Mickey. That's Dolls by Mickey. He does eye chips. He's a photographer. He's sort of like a triple, quadruple threat of talent. And then next to October is my doll from Naoko's Customs. I always get a little bit confused because I think this artist changed their name and I don't remember the initial name. So this is Naoko's Customs. Love this work. And then the girl that's next to her in the little rabbit suit. Now this one's funny, I actually had to reach out for her. I bought this not too long ago from my friend Jenny, and she says, this is the first custom I've ever done, thought I'd sell it. And I thought, are you kidding me? Have you seen my first customs? They are a wreck. Okay, they needed some serious like sandpaper action. So I don't even know if she has a shop, but it was worth including in this bunch. And then on the end there, you might recognize that cutie. That is my Poppy doll. So I got Poppy from Dolls de Jardin. This is a UK artist. And as far as I know, she's been doing dolls that are based on garden flowers, that type of thing. And Poppy is one of my absolute favorites. Okay, and then last but certainly not least is this gathering of dolls. These are very, very special to me. Most of them are gifts, believe it or not. So in the 5+ years that I've been collecting Pullip dolls, I have been so fortunate to meet so many people, and they've been very generous. So I love these dolls. They are my life. And then, of course, on the end, there are a couple very, very special girls that I get excited about still every time I see them. So let's start on the very end with my very, very first custom doll, if you can believe it. I was an early fan of Neri Opozo. She used to put her dolls up on eBay, and this doll, Enmei, was my very, very first custom. I fell in love ever since. It's been a dark, deep spiral of customs ever since then. Next to her is a doll by my friend Amanda, who had a little shop called Lavender Lee Dolls. You know, I don't think she's done any more dolls since this one, and it's a shame because I get so many comments and questions about her. She's so lovely. And then you're going to see sort of this parade of brunettes. Coincidence? I think not. The girl in the pink hat was a gift to me by my friend Michelle. Michelle is wonderful. She's like the expert crafter. I was lucky enough to meet her in New Jersey, and she's like a sister to me. And then next to her is a doll by Poshy Dolls. This was gifted to me by my friend Bruno. Bruno and I had this like weird cosmic decision to exchange dolls, and we didn't say that to each other. It was kind of funny. And then you'll see a couple of dolls here. One is sitting down. That is my Yolame by Magdalena Dolls. This was gifted to me by my friend Art, and I gave her a little makeover. I just changed her wig because, you know, me and my brunettes, but she's so cute. I just love her so much. And then you'll see Joy. That was a full custom done by my bestie, Catherine. She has a shop called Katie Doll Designs. I adore this doll. I'm like one of the 10 people in the world who love the movie Blade Runner, and I just love the Joy character. Okay, so next to her, you might recognize this. I did a video on my Rolf Pullip a few years ago at Puddle. A couple of people came up to me and totally shocked me with this like amazing gift. Everybody was involved. Karen did the Rolf costume, Rolf being my favorite Muppet. Kelly did the face up. People donated wigs and eyes and shoes. It was just amazing. And they put this photo album together, and I cried all the way home from Puddle. No shame, no shame in tears. All right, so the next three dolls are a wedding set that was a very recent surprise for me for a very special occasion. And these dolls are so precious. So the bride was done by my friend Maria. The outfit the bride is wearing is by Luisa from Mota del Algodon. The wonderful Buell, my very first custom Buell, is done by Desiree, and her outfit is done by Gochi. I say these people's names just so lightly, but these are my very best friends in the world, you guys. I adore these humans. And then the groom, who is like the most dashing, handsome guy ever, the face-up was done by Karen. He is so handsome. I love him, and he's actually my first full custom Taiyang. Okay, this turned out to be a really happy video, you guys. I look at all these dolls lined up, and I'm like getting emotional. All right, so you'll notice the next two dolls next to them are a little bit different than anything I own, and that is thanks to Art. So Art had gifted me these two, Voodoo King and Voodoo Queen, when we were hanging out for a special occasion in October, and they are magnificent. The artist is Sajanid, and I promise you I will do a full review of them because they really do deserve it. All right. And finally, the two on the end are not gifts. I spent plenty of money on these two. The first blonde is Subaru by Utopa, Japanese artist. And then there's Kuze, my dream girl, who was a collab doll by Erosinoff and Mota del Algodon. These two dolls, you might remember, are from the Groove Custom Doll Contest, and the original dolls went up for auction. I about passed out when I won them. So these dolls, all of them are very special to me for a reason, but I wanted to group these together because they really do make my heart just explode when I see them all together like this. So anyway, I hope you have enjoyed this tour of my custom dolls as much as I have in reliving all the little memories. If you have any questions at all, again, if you saw some that were missing, never fear. There are some that are just not displayed, but I am happy to answer your questions, and we will talk soon.